Yesterday, children, we have done exercise 2.2. Now we are doing some more questions of exercise 2.2. Do question number 7. Tan inverse under root 1 minus cos x upon 1 plus cos x. Question number 7. Tan inverse under root 1 minus cos x upon 1 plus cos x. You all know the value of 1 minus cos x and 1 plus cos x. I am writing once again. We know the formulas of 1 minus cos 2x is equal to 2 sin square x. And 1 plus cos 2x is equal to 2 cos square x. These two formulas you have done so many times in class 11th. Now we are having 1 minus cos x. So it will become 2 sin square x by 2. And here 1 plus cos x will become 2 cos square x by 2. So we will use these two formulas, this one and this one. So put these value here. So tan inverse 2 sin square x by 2 upon 2 cos square x by 2 under root. 2 is cancelled by 2. So tan inverse tan square x by 2. Tan inverse tan x by 2. Tan is cancelled by tan. So answer is x by 2. Yes. Yes, children. Once again, I am repeating this question. Tan inverse 1 minus cos x upon 1 plus cos x under root. So formula 1 minus cos x from here. 2 sin square x by 2 and 1 plus cos x 2 cos square x by 2. So sin square x by 2 upon cos square x by 2 will become tan square x by 2. Further, after taking under root, we will get tan x by 2. Tan is cancelled by tan inverse. So answer is x by 2. Clear, children? Now do one more question. Tan inverse, question number 9. Tan inverse x upon under root a square minus x square. Tan inverse x upon under root a square minus x square. Yeah, children. Look here clearly. If we put x is equal to a sin theta. So we can put here a sin theta, tan inverse a sin theta upon a square minus a square sin square theta. Tan inverse a sin theta upon a square common 1 minus sin square theta under root. Tan inverse a sin theta upon a 1 minus sin square theta will become cos square theta. So a square cos square theta. So further it will become tan inverse a sin theta upon a cos theta. A is cancelled by a. Tan inverse tan theta. Tan is cancelled by tan. Answer is theta. So what was theta from here? So we will find the value of theta. What we have taken? X is equal to a sin theta. So first of all, take x upon a is equal to sin theta. Then sin inverse will become here. sine inverse x upon a will become equal to theta. So you can put the value of theta from here, sine inverse x upon a. This is the final answer. Once again, children, this is the question. Tan inverse x upon under root a square minus x square. Put x is equal to a sine theta. जब हम x की वैल्यू a sin theta पुट करेंगे तो a square हमारा कॉमन आ जाएगा, अंदर cos square theta बन जाएगा, cos square theta बाहर आने के बाद cos theta बन जाएगा। तो हमें यहाँ ऐसी वैल्यू लेनी होती है जिससे हमारा अंडर रूट रिमूव हो जाए। अगर हम कुछ और वैल्यू लेते हैं x is equal to a tan theta, a sec theta etc, तो हम अंडर रूट रिमूव नहीं कर पाएंगे। तो सिर्फ यही फॉर्मूला इसमें काम करेगा, x is equal to a sin theta. So answer will become sin inverse x upon a. Similarly, do one more question. Question number 10. Tan inverse 3a square x minus x cube. Question number 10. Tan inverse 3a square x minus x cube upon a cube minus 3ax square. अब यहां हम ऐसी वैल्यू पुट करेंगे जिससे अंदर tan थीटा की वैल्यू बन जाए। पुट x इज इक्वल टू a tan थीटा, पुट x इज इक्वल टू a tan थीटा। So it will become tan inverse 3a square a tan theta minus a cube tan cube theta dividing by a cube minus 3a a square tan square theta. Tan inverse 3a cube tan theta minus a cube tan cube theta whole dividing by a cube minus 3a cube tan square theta. Take a cube from numerator and denominator. Tan inverse a cube common 3 tan theta minus tan cube theta dividing by a cube common 1 minus 3 tan square theta. A cube is cancelled by a cube. So tan inverse, this is the formula of tan 3 theta. 3 tan theta minus tan cube theta upon 1 minus 3 tan square theta. This is the formula of tan 3 theta. It was the formula in class 11th also. Tan 3 theta is equal to 3 tan theta minus tan cube theta upon 1 minus 3 tan square theta. So it will become tan 3 theta. So tan is cancelled by tan. So answer is 3 theta. Now put the value of theta from here. X upon a is equal to tan theta. अब इस tan को इधर लाओ, tan inverse x upon a is equal to theta. So we can put this value here. So finally it will become 3 tan inverse x upon a. 3 tan inverse x upon a. So this is the final solution, children. Once again, I am repeating, this was the question. We have to put that value which can make it the formula of tan 3 theta. So x is equal to a tan theta. We are putting x is equal to a tan theta. So a tan theta, a cube tan cube theta, a cube minus 3a, a square tan square theta. So after taking a cube common from numerator and denominator, a cube is cancelled by a cube. So this formula will become tan 3 theta. So 10 inverse is cancelled by 10. So 10 inverse is cancelled by 10. So remaining answer is 3 theta. So putting the value of theta from here, x is equal to a tan theta. X upon a will become 10 theta, and 10 inverse x upon a will become equal to theta. So putting the value of theta here, so answer will become 3 tan inverse x upon a. So this is the final solution. Clear, children? Now do one more question. Question number 13. Question number 13. Tan 1 by 2 sine inverse 2x upon 1 plus x square plus cos inverse 1 minus y square upon 1 plus y square. Simplify. Here, children, you can see 2 tan inverse x is equal to sine inverse 2x upon 1 plus x square. So sine inverse 2x upon 1 plus x square will become 2 tan inverse x directly. This is the direct formula of 2 tan inverse x. 2 tan inverse x will become sine inverse 2x upon 1 plus x square. Similarly, 2 tan inverse y, in terms of cos, cos inverse 1 minus y square upon 1 plus y square. So putting these two value here, so tan 1 by 2 outside, 2 tan inverse x plus 2 tan inverse y, tan outside, take 2 common, 2 tan inverse x plus tan inverse y, 2 is cancelled by 2, so tan outside, this is the formula of tan inverse x plus tan inverse y, this is the formula, tan inverse x plus tan inverse y can be written tan inverse x plus y upon 1 minus x y, so this will become tan inverse x plus y upon 1 minus xy. Tan inverse is cancelled by tan. So answer will become x plus y upon 1 minus xy. So this is the final solution. Clear, children? Repeating once again. Sin inverse 2x, simply we have to put the values of sin inverse 2x upon 1 plus x square is equal to 2 tan inverse x. And cos inverse 1 minus y square upon 1 plus y square, replacing these two values from here. So here you can write 2 tan inverse x, and here you can write 2 tan inverse y. 2 tan inverse x, 2 tan inverse y. Take 2 common. So 2 is cancelled by 2. It will become tan inverse x. Tan inverse x plus tan inverse y. So tan inverse is cancelled by tan. So x plus y upon 1 minus xy will be the remaining answer. The final answer will be x plus y upon 1 minus xy. Clear? Now we are doing some of our more important question. Inverse trigonometric equation in which we have to find the value of x. Tan inverse x minus 1 upon x minus 2. Question number 15. Tan inverse x minus 1 upon x minus 2 plus tan inverse x plus 1 upon x plus 2 is equal to pi by 4. In this situation, we don't want to prove this term plus this term is equal to pi by 4. In this term, tan inverse x minus 1 upon x minus 2 tan inverse x plus 1 upon x plus 2 is given equal to pi by 4. We have to find the value of x from here. So there it is called inverse trigonometric equation, or solve that inverse trigonometric equation. So first of all, we will apply the formula of tan inverse x plus tan inverse y. So here this is x and this is y. So using the formula of tan inverse x plus tan inverse y, so tan inverse x minus 1 upon x minus 2 plus x plus 1 upon x minus x plus 2 dividing by 1 minus x minus 1 upon x minus 2 into x plus 1 upon x plus 2. For the solving, so x minus 1 into x plus 2 plus x plus 1 into x minus 2 dividing by the LCM x minus 2 into x plus 2. X minus 2 into x plus 2, x minus 2 into x plus 2 minus x minus 1 into x plus 1 dividing by x minus 2 into x plus 2. This is cancelled by this. X minus 1 into x minus 2, multiplying these situations, so this will become x square minus x plus 2x minus 2 plus x square minus 2x plus x minus 2 dividing by x square minus 4 minus x square minus 1. So further it will become tan inverse x square plus x square 2x square minus x plus x cancel, 2x 2x cancel, minus 2 minus 2, it will become minus 4 whole dividing by x square minus 4 minus x square plus 1, and that is equal to pi by 4. So x square is cancelled by x square. Tan inverse 2x square minus 4 upon minus 3. It is equal to tan, it is equal to pi by 4. So 2x square minus 4 upon minus 3 is equal to tan pi by 4. So tan pi by 4, tan 45 will become equal to 1. So finally it will become tan 2x square minus 4 upon minus 3 is equal to minus 1. So 2x square minus 4 is equal to minus 3. Minus 3. So 2x square is equal to 4 minus 3. So 2x square will become equal to 4 minus 3, that is 1. X square will become equal to 1 by 2 and x will become equal to plus minus 1 by root 2. Plus minus 1 by root 2. Clear, children? First of all, I am repeating once again. First of all, this is the question. Tan inverse this plus tan inverse this is equal to pi by 4. This is given already. Now, we have to apply the formula of tan inverse x plus tan inverse y. This will become tan inverse x plus y upon 1 minus xy. After solving, we will get, after cancelling these two LCM, and after solving, we will get x square minus x plus 2x minus 2 plus x square minus 2x plus x minus 2 upon x square minus 4 minus x square minus 1. So it will become 2x square minus 4, it will become x square minus 4 minus x square plus 1, that is minus 3, 2x square minus 4 upon minus 3. Take this tan inverse to that side, this will become tan pi by 4. ये tan inverse उधर जाके tan pi by 4 बन जाएगा, tan pi by 4, tan 45 वैल्यू 1 होती है. अब इस minus 3 का क्रॉस मल्टीप्लाई करेंगे, तो 2x square minus 4 is equal to minus 3, so 2x square is equal to 4 minus 3, that will become 1, x square will become is equal to 1 by 2, and x will become plus minus 1 by root 2. So So this is the final answer of this question. Clear, children? Do one more question. Question number 16. साइन इनवर्स साइन टू पाई बाय थ्री एंड क्वेश्चन नंबर 19 कॉस सेवन पाई बाय सिक्स Children, generally we cancel sine inverse by sine, but here we cannot cancel these two terms because sine 2 pi by 3 means sine 120, sine inverse sine 120 or sine 120, 120 degree angle is second quadrant, this is 120 degree angle और यहां sine की range नहीं होती है, sine की range क्या होती है, minus pi by 2 से plus pi by 2. या तो एंगल फर्स्ट क्वाड्रेंट का होना चाहिए या एंगल फोर्थ क्वाड्रेंट का होना चाहिए, लेकिन ये एंगल है सेकंड क्वाड्रेंट का, 120 डिग्री एंगल सेकंड क्वाड्रेंट में आता है. तो पहले इस एंगल को हम चेंज करेंगे, पहले इस एंगल को फर्स्ट क्वाड्रेंट में या फोर्थ क्वाड्रेंट में कन्वर्ट करेंगे, क्योंकि साइन की रेंज होती है माइनस पाई बाय टू प्लस पाई बाय टू. ये सबसे पहली बार हमने यही बताया था, टू फाइंड द प्रिंसिपल वैल्यूज ऑफ साइन इनवर्स कॉस इनवर्स एक्सेट्रा एक्सेट्रा. तो 120 डिग्री एंगल जब तक यहां है तो साइन से साइन कैंसिल हम नहीं कर पाएंगे. तो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल कन्वर्ट इट इनटू स्मॉलर एंगल, साइन इनवर्स साइन 180 माइनस 60, दिस कैन बी रिटन लाइक दिस एंड वी नो दैट साइन 180 माइनस थीटा इज इक्वल टू साइन थीटा प्लस साइन थीटा. साइन इनवर्स साइन 180 माइनस थीटा विल बिकम साइन थीटा. नाउ वी कैन कैंसिल, अब ये फर्स्ट क्वाड्रेंट का एंगल, नाउ वी कैन कैंसिल इट बिकॉज अब ये माइनस पाई बाय टू और प्लस पाई बाय टू के बीच में आ गया है. तो नाउ वी कैन कैंसिल साइन इनवर्स बाय साइन, सो 60 डिग्री और पाई बाय थ्री इज द आंसर. क्लियर स्टूडेंट? वंस अगेन आई एम रिपीटिंग, वी कैन नॉट कैंसिल साइन बाय साइन इनवर्स because 2 pi by 3 is 120 degree angle and 120 degree angle is the second quadrant angle and in second quadrant sine cannot be cancelled by sine. So first of all convert this 120 degree angle into a smaller one in first quadrant or in fourth quadrant. So 120 can be written 180 minus 60. So sine 180 minus 60 is equal to sine 60. Sine 180 minus theta, you can write sine 180 minus theta is equal to plus sine theta. Is equal to plus sine theta. So using this formula, sine 180 minus theta is equal to plus sine theta. So it will become sine 180 minus 60 is equal to sine 60. Now we can cancel sine inverse by sine. So answer is 60 degree. 60 degree means pi by 3. So pi by 3 is the final answer. Similarly here also, 7 pi by 6. What is the range of sine cos? Range of cos is 0 to pi. Cos की range यहां से यहां तक होती है. अगर ये वाला angle इससे बड़ा है तो we cannot cancel cos also. तो सबसे पहले 7 pi by 6 कितना degree angle है? Pi by 6 means 30 and 37 जा 210. So simply writing in cos 210. ये second quadrant का angle नहीं है. तो 0 टू पाई के बीच में ये एंगल होना चाहिए, लेकिन ये एंगल है 210, दैट इज थर्ड क्वाड्रेंट एंगल. तो इस थर्ड क्वाड्रेंट एंगल को पहले सेकंड क्वाड्रेंट या फर्स्ट क्वाड्रेंट में हम कन्वर्ट करेंगे फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल. सो दिस इज, दिस कैन बी रिटन कॉस इनवर्स कॉस 180 प्लस 30. in third quadrant cos is negative. So we can write cos inverse minus cos 30. और जब तक ये माइनस साइन यहां है तब तक भी हम इस कॉस को कॉस से कैंसिल नहीं करेंगे. फर्स्ट वी विल रिमूव दिस माइनस साइन, देन वी विल कैंसिल कॉस बाय कॉस. तो नाउ रिमूविंग दिस वन, कॉस इनवर्स कैन बी रिटर्न कॉस इनवर्स कॉस 180 माइनस 30. कॉस 180 माइनस थीटा इज ऑल्सो इक्वल टू माइनस कॉस थीटा. यू कैन राइट हियर cos 180 minus theta is equal to minus cos theta. So furthermore we can write cos inverse cos 30. cos 180 minus theta is minus cos theta. ये minus cos theta, minus cos 30 को ऐसे लिख सकते हैं. So 180 minus 30 it will become cos 150. cos 150. Listen once again, children. First of all, remove 210. Convert 210. 180 plus 30. Cos 180 plus 30, third quadrant angle. So it will become minus cos 30. अब ये minus यहाँ से हटाना है, तो remove this minus sign. Cos 180 minus 30 is minus cos 30. Cos 180 plus 30 minus cos 30, and cos 180 minus 30 is also minus cos 30. So 180 minus 30, it will become 150. So cos is cancelled by cos. So answer is 150. Or we can write it is equal to 5 pi by 6. Pi by 6, 30 degree angle, and 5 multiply, it is will become 150 degree angle. So cos cannot be cancelled by cos because this angle lie in third quadrant. If it lie in second quadrant, we can cancel directly. Clear, children? So answer is 5 pi by 6. Similarly, you can do 2-3 more questions, children. Now I am starting miscellaneous exercise of chapter 2. Miscellaneous exercise of chapter 2. Miscellaneous exercise of chapter 2. Now do question number 3. 2 sine inverse 3 by 5. 2 sine inverse 3 by 5 is equal to, prove that it is equal to tan inverse 24 by 7. So in such type of question, what we have to do, children? This should be tan or this should be sine. First of all, you have to convert both the things in the same identity. So first of all, convert sine 3 upon 5 in terms of tan. So first of all, let theta is equal to sine inverse 3 upon 5. So it will become sine theta is equal to 3 upon 5. Then make the triangle like 10th class. Make the triangle. This is perpendicular and this is hypotenuse. So perpendicular is 3 and hypotenuse is 5. So 5 square minus 3 square is equal to 25 minus 9. It will become equal to 16. So base will become 4. Now we can convert into tan also. So tan theta will become equal to 3 upon 4. Clear, children? Sin theta was equal to 3 upon 5 and tan theta will become 3 upon 4. So theta will become equal to tan inverse 3 by 4. So what we have taken theta? Theta was equal to tan inverse 3 by 5 and here theta is tan inverse 3 by 4. So put here. Now start the question once again. So putting the value of 2 into tan inverse 3 by 4 is equal to tan inverse 24 by 7. Now this is the question right now. 2 tan inverse 3 by 4 we have to prove equal to tan inverse 24 by 7. Now we know the formula 2 tan inverse x. 2 tan inverse x in terms of tan inverse. So ye formula yahan se yahan lagega. 2 is 2 ko hatane ke liye hame tan ko isme convert karna padega. यहाँ 2 नहीं होना चाहिए, जब ये 2 यहाँ से हटेगा तो ये फॉर्मूला यूज होगा. तो 2 tan इनवर्स x, दिस इज x एंड दिस इज 2 tan इनवर्स x. सो वी नो द फॉर्मूला ऑफ 2 tan इनवर्स x इज इक्वल टू tan इनवर्स 2x अपॉन 1 माइनस x स्क्वायर. सो हियर यू कैन अप्लाई 2 tan इनवर्स 3 बाय 4 इट विल बिकम इक्वल टू tan इनवर्स 2 into 3 by 4 upon 1 minus 3 by 4 square. So 2, 2 is 4. So tan inverse 3 by 2 upon 1 minus 9 by 16 is equal to tan inverse 3 by 2, 16 minus 9, 7 by 16. Further, it will become tan inverse 3 into 16 upon 2 into 7. So, 2, 8 is 16. So, tan inverse 3 into 8 by 7. That is equal to tan inverse 24 by 7. Tan inverse 24 by 7. Prove children. Once again, 2 sin inverse 3 by 5 is equal to, we have to prove tan inverse 24 by 7. So first of all, convert this sin inverse 3 upon 5 in terms of tan. तो tan में convert करने के लिए सबसे पहले हमें triangle बनाना पड़ेगा. इस पूरी term को theta मान लेते हैं. Theta is equal to sin inverse 3 upon 5. So sin theta will become equal to 3 upon 5. 3 is perpendicular and 5 is hypotenuse. So 3 is perpendicular, 5 is hypotenuse. So we can find the base. 25 minus 9 will become 16 and square root of 16 will become 4. So tan theta is equal to perpendicular upon base, that will become 3 upon 4. So theta will become tan inverse 3 by 4. अब tan inverse की वैल्यू 3 by 4 आ गई. थीटा की वैल्यू, तो उस थीटा की वैल्यू को हम यहाँ पुट कर सकते हैं. तो 2 tan inverse 3 by 4, उसके बाद हमने ये वाला फॉर्मूला यूज किया है tan को tan में कन्वर्ट करने का. 2 tan inverse x is equal to tan inverse 2x upon 1 minus x square. तो 2 tan inverse 3 by 4 is equal to tan inverse 2 into 3 by 4 upon 1 minus 3 by 4 square. 2 को 4 से कट कर दिया, 2 आ गया है. उसके बाद इसका एलसीएम लिया और एलसीएम लेके ये आ गया tan inverse 3 into 8 upon 7. That is tan inverse 24 by 7. Tan inverse 24 by 7. This is tan inverse 24 by 7. Some more questions are remaining, children. So we will do day after tomorrow these questions. Thank you.